Hi guys, Kibo here, doing another review today of a book called On the Beach by Neville Shute. This is actually a first edition novel I'm holding it. As you can see, that's the spine. It's very, very worn, some pages are coming out, and as you can see, that's all the pages are there. This particular book is from the Ackland Public Library. It says Perfect Contentment, Perfect Book. Very, very 1950s. The book came out in 1957 and 58, I believe. This one is the Australian edition. So it is a fairly old novel, and once again it was, well, like my last review, I also mentioned it and made reference to On the Beach. This is funny. It even says the rules of the public library, and at the back it's got all the date stamps. I bought this one for about $20. I believe in very good condition. They're worth maybe $200-$300. But this one, perhaps not. I bought it for, I think, $20 a few years ago before I got round to reading it. It is an Australian classic. It's what Neville Shute is most well known for. He has written some other works, but none as comparable to On the Beach, which he is most well known for, and it is a famous classic Australian novel. There's a couple of movies being made about it. What was it, 1965 or something? Somewhere around that time, 1959. It was made fairly quickly into a black and white movie, which was also based in Melbourne, which the entire novel is based around the city of Melbourne in Australia. It brought a lot of spotlight to Melbourne for reasons, just simply because of the book. Basically, the book is the 1950s movie, the black and white movie. I believe there also is a colour edition, but don't quote me on that. But it's an okay movie. I imagine it was fairly groundbreaking for its time. That's the 1950s. What got my attention originally was the late 90s made for TV Australian Aussie 3 hours, 4 hours made for TV movie, which was a pretty big thing. I remember them making a big deal about it back in the 90s when I was fairly still young. Maybe 13, 12. So the movie. If you've heard about the movie or the book, you would have heard it. It is most likely the first thing you would have heard is the themes it is based around, which is themes of almost like a. It is a nuclear apocalypse theme genre of book. While it was still fairly new for its time to have apocalypse scenario books, I think that's what made it so groundbreaking. I just want to talk a little bit about the story. The way Neville Shute writes the book, and the way he writes a lot of his other books, it's a very depressing scenario. He's even written another book that was about the Depression, and the person doesn't give in to self-pity, they don't give in to self-loathing. It's like he took a antidepressant pill. He decided to write about the worst case scenario and talk about a bunch of people that have taken antidepressants, and it's like they're talking. It's a very happy sort of. Anyway, it's very happy for the circumstances it surrounds. For example, My opinion is that it isn't actually a science fiction novel. It seems to be more focused on a romance theme. Or it should be more under a romance genre, so I believe that's what may have attracted a lot of people back in the 50s to the book rather than the actual sci-fi nuclear apocalypse themes. That's probably what did make it a very, very popular book and quickly pushed it into an Australian classic. The themes is mainly about romance. It is also about military, so it can be said like to be almost a cross-military, cross-romance book, where they do go in the submarine, and it's very official, very formal, the language that's sort of used. And it's quite odd, some of the situations they talk about, because they seem very placid in their eventual fate. They seem very placid in the way that things are going to eventuate. So once again, it is set in Melbourne. The scenario is that presumably the Russians and the Americans went to nuclear war, and I think in the modern movie that's been changed to the Chinese and the Russians, but don't quote me again on that. The submarine is an American submarine that didn't fire, that went into, I believe it's nuclear powered submarine, that went that didn't fire, and basically on the beach means the actual term, I believe, means to be relieved of your command in military service. So if you were to be said, oh, he's on the beach, it means he's been relieved of his command. So I guess that's what they're talking about with Colonel Dwight Towers and what are some of the other names? Osborne, which is the scientist, Dwight Towers, Peter. Anyway, there's a few characters, and it is like a pulp riff. It's like a pulp fiction sort of novel, because one chapter it's talking about one character, the next chapter it's talking about another character. So it isn't a flowing story like that. Often the span of the story crosses many countries and continents. It talks about where the submarine goes to America and past Cairns and to Auckland and to Asia. I think Neville Shute does that in a lot of his novels. I don't believe he particularly chose Melbourne for any other reason than its geographic location from the rest of the world, for it to be set in the case of a nuclear fallout. So basically the nuclear fallout cloud is coming down towards Melbourne, and the people do seem very placid, and there is a lot of talk about suicide and hope. It's mainly, people talk a lot about hope in the book, and I guess that's what makes it such a positive book, that they hope people will come back and find the civilization. So they put all of civilizations, they put the complete story of civilization onto stones on the top of Mount Kosciuszko, which is the largest mountain in Australia, just in case somebody ever comes back, which I found really profound, that it was so hopeful that they were hoping that another human race would come back. And it talks about how Mother Earth will keep on going, but it's just a very small blip on the story of Mother Earth over millions and billions of years. So it's very interesting, it's very hopeful the way they talk. Not that they understand that the human race and has been eradicated, but that for some reason it's very, very hopeful. The film actually does leave you pretty gutted because it is so much more intense. It's one of the few times where I'd even say the film was better than the book. I really liked the made-for-TV film. It really elaborated on the book without it stepping over the book's toes. If anything, it was made better than the book. So if you've seen the movie, don't expect the book to be better than the movie. Possibly the 1950s movie would be better. It was a good read. I wouldn't probably read it again. I'd recommend it as an Australian classic read, or as a 1950s Cold War era paranoid read, just to see what people were having to sort of experience as a paranoia about nuclear weapons in that era. And I also believe even the United States responded to the book that there isn't enough nuclear weapons for a case scenario to happen like on the beach. I believe they did even mention the book or the movie. So apparently it is still a science fiction idea and has always been that we do have that capacity to enter to where Melbourne is, the last place on Earth. It is, obviously we have Tasmania, but Tasmania isn't mentioned, and well, it is mentioned actually, it's just they realise there's no point in travelling further south to escape the inevitable, so it's all the industries come to a halt. It's a very interesting way the society, he describes a society breaking down over time, and people stop turning up to work, and it's bizarre that, you know, to think people still would turn up to work 2 weeks before the their deaths, but I suppose it is possible. We can't really know. So it certainly happened in Stalingrad, so maybe it was a different day and age this was written in, but I don't see people in my suburb turning up to their jobs if they had 2 weeks to live. Is there anything else I could say about the book? I'll give it 3 stars, but because it is an Australian classic and I am an Australian classic myself, I'll give it 4 stars. It was a bit hard to digest a little bit. Just I was expecting something a bit different from the novel, but it is, as I said, if you're expecting a sci-fi novel, you'll get a romance novel, which is it's a bit of an unexpected. Considering the movie wasn't that much about romance, there is one more twist I want to mention. The book does differ from the made-for-TV movie right at the end, and once again the made-for-TV movie is the happier of the two, where the book kind of doesn't leave you on a happier note. I'm not sure why they often do. Well, I do know it's to leave the audiences not feeling so gutted after they've seen the movie, and so it does. The book doesn't necessarily leave on a happy note and a happily live after note. So I'll leave that to you guys. So if you watch the movie as well, once again, if you are feeling a bit depressed or suicidal, it is. It deals heavily with those themes, and the book isn't so much about dealing with the themes of the government giving out suicide pills, for example, which is one thing And they were giving it out on Flinders Street steps, which is really, that's one thing that stuck with me in a movie, that the government's giving out suicide pills on streets of Parliament. Sorry, it was on the streets of Parliament, which is, yeah, that's, I hope it, our day and age never comes to that, to see that happen. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. See you later. Which was also based in Melbourne, which the entire novel is based around the city of Melbourne in Australia. It brought a lot of spotlight to Melbourne for reasons just simply because of the book. Basically, the book is the 1950s movie, the black and white movie. I believe there also is a colour edition, but don't quote me on that. But it's an okay movie. It was, I imagine it was fairly groundbreaking for its time. That's the 1950s. What got my attention originally was the late 90s made for TV Australian Aussie 3 hours, 4 hours made for TV movie, which was a pretty big thing. I remember them making a big deal about it back in the 90s when I was fairly still young. This is funny. It even says the rules of the public library, and at the back it's got all the date stamps. I bought this one for about $20, I believe, in very good condition. They're worth maybe $200-$300, but this one perhaps not. I bought it for, I think, $20 a few years ago before I got round to reading it. It is an Australian classic. It's what Neville Shute is most well known for. He has written some other works, but none as comparable to On the Beach, which he's most well known for, and it is a famous classic Australian novel. For those, there's a couple of movies being made about it. What was it, 1965 or something? Somewhere around that time, 1959, it was made fairly quickly into a black and white movie. Hi guys, Kivo here, doing another review today of a book called On the Beach by Neville Shute. This is actually a first edition novel I'm holding. As you can see, that's the spine. It's very, very worn. Some pages are coming out, and as you can see, that's all the pages are there. This particular book is from the Auckland Public Library. It says "Perfect Contentment, Perfect Book." Very, very 1950s. The book came out in 1957 and 58, I believe. This one is the Australian edition. So it is a fairly old novel, and once again, it was, well, like my last review, I also mentioned it and made reference to On the Beach. It'll give in to self-loathing. It's like he took a antidepressant pill. He decided to write about the worst case scenario and talk about a bunch of people that have taken antidepressants, and it's like they're talking. It's a very happy sort of. Anyway, it's very happy for the circumstances it surrounds. For example, my opinion is that it isn't actually a science fiction novel. It seems to be more focused on a romance theme, or it should be more under a romance genre. So I believe that's what may have attracted a lot of people back in the 50s to the book, rather than the actual sci-fi nuclear apocalypse themes. That's probably what did make it a very, very popular book, and quickly pushed it into an Australian classic. the theme, maybe 13, some 12. So the movie, if you've heard about the movie or the book, you would have heard it. It is the most likely the first thing you would have heard is the themes it is based around, which is themes of almost like a it is a nuclear apocalypse theme genre of book. While it was still fairly new for its time to have apocalypse scenario books, I think that's what made it so groundbreaking. I just want to talk a little bit about the story. The way Neville Shute writes the book, and the way he writes a lot of his other books, it's a very depressing scenario. He's even written another book that was about the depression, and it's the person doesn't give in to self-pity. They don't.